The thistles, here's a nice patch here on the side of this hill. There's lots of it going right now. And if you, I have gloves on because they are sharp. That's, you know, thistles, people may be familiar that thistles have thorns. What we like to go for is this nice stalk. So when it starts to send up the flower spike before the stalk, before it gets too tough, you just have to peel off the spikes. Just kind of like you peel the thing like you're peeling like a celery stalk, basically. Thistles and artichokes are actually very closely related. Artichoke is really a type of thistle. It's in a different genus, Cynara, but it is basically a thistle. The thing is, if you find one thistle and you don't like it, it's too tough or too bitter, then go to the next one. You want to make sure you get all the spikes off, though. Nice and juicy and sweet. And when you first bite down, it crunches a lot like celery. It's got a great crunch, but then afterward you see it's very fibrous and stringy. So, it gets much, much better up here. I got a little bit, you know, higher up on this thistle stalk, and this is delicious. I mean, you can just crunch on it like celery. It's sweet and crunchy and juicy, and makes me feel. So you can just get that, and you can, like, let's say, cut off the leaves really quick. And then you can maybe, you know, put this in the bag, and then you can, do it later, all at once, rather than right here in the field. Another way you could do this, as I've demonstrated before in the wild artichoke thistle video, is you can actually take like a machete, or a, you know, really sharp, like big knife, and just kind of, and that's a really quick way to knock them down too. But there's something nice about taking it slow and respecting the power and beauty of the thistle. We're in this giant thistle patch here next to this beautiful valley oak tree. This is all thistles growing underneath it, which again are considered to be an invasive weed. And because of the shade and sort of the soil protection and everything that this valley oak offers, the thistles here are a lot lusher and, you know, bigger than they are out in the field. And they're not quite as much in the flowering stage. And so typically, you know, that means they're going to be more tender, more succulent, and less tough and fibrous as they would be out there, and of course bigger. So we're under here harvesting them, not just because this tree's beautiful, because it's actually a nice place to forage for thistle. And if you look, that's one of the leaves that we cut off. And that's, you know, that's really big for this type of thistle. So we got quite a few down there, and been working on. So we picked them in the bags really quick, like you saw earlier. And we're just sitting up here on this beautiful rock and this amazing, stunning view, and just peeling them, and gonna take that bag home. And I mean, that's quite a bit there already that we've been doing. You just kind of whittle away at it with a knife. So when you get down toward the end, it's really tasty and juicy down here, but it's actually a lot harder to peel. So sometimes I'll just get rid of the end like that. Get another bag. So this is a uber sustainable food, and it's delicious. I've been eating them here. Some of them are so crunchy, it's like celery or even a cucumber. I mean, it's really like this clear, crunchy, just amazing flavor. Very mild, there's no bitterness at all. And it's quite meditative just sitting up here and peeling these. I highly recommend doing this out in a beautiful place rather than in the kitchen, which is normally where I do things. For efficiency's sake, but you know, when the weather's good, in springtime, it's nice to be outside, to just kind of sit there and do this outside. Also, that way you don't get thorns all over your kitchen too, is another another consideration. That's thistle, that's a Cirsium species, the non-native thistle.